Good afternoon, Max Brantley with the Arkansas Times on Tuesday, October the 2nd. Well, here's a piece of good news for workers for Amazon. It announced today that effective November 1st, its minimum wage is going to go up to $15 an hour. That's for all its workers, full-time, part-time, temporary workers. That should include, of course, some people they're about to hire in North Little Rock to handle a temporary package facility here. I remind you that Chamber of Commerce officials who didn't make much of an effort to get Amazon here, thought it was a bridge too far for us, are also behind the campaign that says $8.50 an hour is just as high as our minimum wage and Arkansas needs to be. Anything else will be bad for business, not bad for Amazon, apparently. Well, John Thurston, the state land commissioner who's running for Secretary of State, continues to maintain silence on the disclosure yesterday by Blue Hog Report that he spent almost $30,000 of his office public money to buy what appears to be a bass boat and rig it out with everything you need to go fishing. He's claimed it's for debris removal. He hadn't proved that he ever used it for that purpose. He's still saying mum. His opponent, Susan Inman, said today that she's got a plan to get more people voting in Arkansas with a vote by mail program. That's something John Thurston also won't talk about. If you find him, you might ask him. UAMS and Arkansas Children's Hospital yesterday announced that they'd come to a new deal for a cooperative arrangement that has doctors working at both Children's and at UAMS. This deal almost fell apart late last week. There's some changes in prerogatives, particularly Children's Hospital wants to bring over some specialists solely to their staff, but apparently things have been worked out. I've just posted the terms of that agreement on the Arkansas blog. You can find it there. State tax money still comes in robustly, up 8% in September over the same month last year. The first 3 months of the year, we've built up about a $30 million surplus against what's been budgeted. They've been cutting money, spending all over the state. Perhaps we could spend more on services. I don't think that's what the governor has in mind. Ascent Children's Health, which has provided a range of behavioral health for children around the state, has announced that it's closing all 10 of its centers soon. The State Department of Human Services says there may be other providers to step in for them. We don't know yet if this has to do with the state's plan to cut spending in mental health areas, but you have to suspect that might have something to do with it. Speaking of behavioral health, Bonnie Agoss, who used to be the chief operating officer of Preferred Family Healthcare, has written an interesting letter to the editor of the Springfield Business Journal, saying that the full story isn't being told about Preferred Family Health, where she was fired at the first of this year. It's been enmeshed in scandal, some dozen people convicted, pleaded guilty, or implicated in a vast scandal involving Medicaid money. She says the full story isn't being told about the good services they do. Undoubtedly, there are some. She still hadn't made herself available to reporters, however. Well, October 8th, I think that's Monday next week, ATN will begin a series of airings of debates for the top four state offices and four congressional seats. This will be a rare opportunity to see the incumbents in those offices, all Republicans. They've been avoiding meeting up with their opponents on the campaign trail, prefer not to. You can find the schedule at AETN. Also today, bad news out in Southwest Little Rock. Nobody hurt, I'm happy to say. Gunshots fired in the neighborhood of Southwest Little Rock and Maple Vale hit the back of Chico Elementary School. Nobody was hurt. Sometimes it's not safe just even to go to school. Here's an interesting lawsuit filed in federal court today, and it might eventually have broad implications. The American Atheist Organization and several individual plaintiffs have sued State Senator Jason Rapert, the Republican, for blocking them from his social media accounts. He doesn't like critics to get after him on Twitter and Facebook. The lawsuit says this is a constitutional violation. There have been some similar lawsuits elsewhere in the country, including against Donald Trump. Lower district courts have said that when you public officials use these accounts and open them up as public forums, everybody needs to be able to talk. Jason Rapert doesn't have much use for atheists. The lawsuit claims they're being discriminated against on the count of a religion, which you may know is prohibited by the First Amendment of the Constitution. Jason Rapert likes the Second Amendment a bit more than the First. Well, elsewhere, we've got it's the continuing saga of Brett Kavanaugh's. Senator Mitch McConnell, the Republican majority leader, seems intent on getting him voted and confirmed to the Supreme Court by the end of this week. Doesn't matter how many bar fights he's been in, how many lies he's told over the years, how mean a drunk he's been, how many women have accused him of sexual assault. Mitch McConnell wants him on the Supreme Court, and if he can hold his Republican senators together, he will be. But we can resist until that happens. I'm Max Brantley. I'll be back tomorrow.
If you listen to our music, you will feel it. You feel it in here.
the music is surviving, probably more than ever.
We owe it to New Orleans, we owe it to the world to keep it going.
It's a feeling that you have that was deep in you, powerful.
What is Mardi Gras Indian to New Orleans? Mardi Gras Indians is New Orleans.
We created rock and roll. We created swing, you know what I'm saying?